we saw our first grayness sharks out from Gibbon, and then we saw our big batches of them at Seal Rocks, and we went up and down the coast many, many places, and there were hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of grayness, just hundreds. I mean, great schools. And we realised very quickly that they were harmless, and we could swim amongst them, and they would move aside and let us pass through the schools. During the 60s and early 70s, the powerhead was invented. And the great heroes went down and powerheaded sharks and dragged them up the beach while the onlookers cheered, I guess. And there was a tremendous decline in grey nurse sharks. And that's when I started writing letters to the Minister of Fisheries about having them protected. Many of the areas where there were grey nurse in the old days, back in the 60s, there are none anymore. But there are still pockets along the coast, but they're far and few between. If we don't do something to protect the habitat, it's not protecting the shark itself, it's protecting the place it lives as well, because if you don't protect the habitat of the shark, it's going to die out anyway. It's all very well to say we're going to protect the kangaroos and then cut down all the forest and remove all the grass. No, they're not going to live. That's how it is. The Wobbegong shark's also in trouble, along with most of our marine life and our marine wilderness areas. The only way to save it for the future, and we're just on the cusp of losing it all together in some cases, is totally protected areas, no-take zones, large no-take zones, where all these animals can live and breed and love, and their babies, their juveniles will trickle out into the rest of the oceans and repopulate. That's what we have to have. And I have seen many, many sharks, dozens and dozens, and probably you have too, with hooks and lines in their mouths. I have seen a shark with the line coming out of its gills and slowly cutting the steel trace, cutting through the gills. I have seen sharks that have swallowed hooks, very, very thin, and they are going to die. They have no hope. They don't live in very deep water. That's a scientific fact. We don't need any more research about the subject. We know enough to know what has to be done and what will happen if we don't do it. What we need now is action. And unfortunately, it's extremely hard to get any action. The government does not want to upset the fishermen. We need action. We have to have protected areas if we are to save even 1% of our marine wilderness areas for the future.